Hey, today we're talking about the top 5 fun things to do in Chesapeake, Virginia. Let's go, baby. Hey, welcome to the channel, or welcome back to the channel. You know what we do here. We talk everything live, work, and play in the coastal Virginia area. That includes Norfolk, that includes Virginia Beach, that's Chesapeake, and all the surrounding cities. Today, we're going to talk about the top 5 fun things to do in, Chesapeake. We're going to hit a little bit indoors, a little bit outdoors. But before we hit that, if you do me a huge favor at the end of this, if I've earned it, hit that like button. It lets the algorithm know, and me know, that I'm doing now putting out content that you enjoy. And if you'd like to see more of it, well, you can hit that little subscribe button with the bell notification. Everything drops on Mondays and Fridays, and we'll see you then. And as much as I love making this content, I'd love more to help you with your real estate needs. And that's what we do on a regular basis for a profession, is help people buy, sell, and move in and out of the area as smooth as possible. I'm on the real estate side, my wife's on the mortgage side, and we'd love to serve your family. So if you'd like a time with us to discuss about what your plans might be, there's usually a link down below where you can hop right into our schedules. It's a Calendly link, sort of like a doctor's office. You can just go in there, select the time that works best for you, and we'll see you then. Or you can shoot us a text or shoot us an email with all the contact information. That's probably right below my face. All right, so let's roll into the top 5 fun things in Chesapeake to do. Now, I know I do a little bit of teasing. I've teased with Sean a few times off camera that Chesapeake's kind of boring. But the main reason people go to Chesapeake is because they want to be outside or they want space. And so a lot of the list today is going to be covering that. So the first thing we're going to hit is outdoor parks or outdoor like places to go. This can include hiking and kayaking. This could be paddle boarding. This could be going on trails. This could be dog parks, but really there's a lot of great outdoor spaces in Chesapeake. That's a little more spread out. You have the Great Dismal Swamp down there, which is worse than what it sounds, but it provides a lot of green space. And a lot of people go down to Chesapeake specifically because they like the outdoor lifestyle. So number one on this outdoor list is going to be the Chesapeake Arboretum, which is going to be a great place to take the kids to go learn about the local flora and fauna. Next on the list is going to be Northwest River Park, which is over 700 acres of hiking and camping. They've got a place where you can go paddleboarding and kayaking. They've got fishing. They have those big, what are those things called, Sean, where you like you pedal?
And, it's a paddle boat.
I don't know. Well, you sit in it and you pedal like you would a bike and it goes around the pond. Whatever those things are called, I'm sure Sean will put it over my shoulder. We actually go here several times a year. The last time we were out there, we took the dog, and they absolutely loved it. We'll go out. They've got great campsites. I will say that if you had a lot of heavy rain, it's probably best to go early to pick out a camping spot because there are certain sections that get kind of swampy, and you want to make sure you get one of those primo spots. They do have showers there as well, which is fantastic, so you don't have to go there and just be smelly. If you need to go and take a nice shower, you can do that. Next on the list is going to be Battlefield Park, and that's going to be the monument that commemorates the Battle of Great Bridge. So you get a little bit of history there, and then also a place, some green space, so you can take the kids to go play. You have the Chesapeake Planetarium. Now, I realize this is not totally outdoors, but it is outdoors oriented. It's the actual, the oldest planetarium in Virginia. But if you want to go a place to look at the stars, no place better. Next up on the list is going to be Chesapeake Park. It's about a 90-acre park. There are lots of sports that are hosted here. They also have one of the coolest, largest wood playgrounds available in the area, those old school ones where if you smacked your shins in it. And then they also host festivals and concerts here. I believe the Jubilee concert and the, I'm going to look down because I can't remember what it's called, the Chesapeake Park Whisper Concert Series. There are more than this. I want to make sure I though mention the Great Dismal Swamp there in Lake Drummond. Lots of people go out there to go fishing and kayaking and paddleboarding. Again, you make sure that you take some mosquito spray or bug spray. It is a large area of stagnant water, so occasionally there are going to be lots of bugs, and you want to make sure that you have get the powerful stuff, man. Just go for the stuff that probably is going to be irritant, but trust me, or take me with you. I tend to attract mosquitoes, like I have the whatever the blood type is or whatever it is that maybe I just need to shower more often, but whatever it is that I need to do, like, is part of me. I attract mosquitoes more than anybody that I know, so I can go with you and they'll just bite me. Rolling on to number two is going to be breweries, and you have the Big Ugly Brewing Company, and then you have the Garage Brewery. Big Ugly opened up in 2015 by Jim Lantry and Sean Childers. After winning a few home brewing competitions, they decided, hey, let's put this to good use and actually serve beer to the community. And they did that. You can notice the brewery because as you drive by, you'll see a 1955 Chevy panel truck that they actually restored together and is kind of the symbol of the brewery. They have kind of carried that theme throughout. There is the automotive theme. I think we did an interview here, and Sean probably already has some really great B-roll of the auto parts throughout the entire atmosphere. One of the really funny things I think that's in there, at least I hope they still have it, is they have a water tap in the back that is, it has, I think it's a Bud Light handle, isn't it? Yeah, so it's a Bud Light, you know, mocking Bud Light, that it actually is water, which, yeah, to a degree it is. They did medal in the Great American Brewing Festival not too long ago with their Ghost Rider Porter. So if you want to try an award-winning drink, that might be one to check out. The Garage Brewery was opened in 2019 by Yulana Gomez. She was a previous real estate investor and decided, hey, as much as I've been successful at this, I'm going to go on to something that's a little bit more about passion. And so she has created something very unique. It's a very small place. They always have revolving food trucks coming in and out of, so it might be really worth checking out more than once so that you can pair those food trucks with their vast array of brews that they do there in-house. Rolling on to number three is going to be indoor activities. So obviously if it's raining outside or if it's freaking hot and you need some AC, well, we need some options to do some things. You have the Defy Trampoline Park. If you've never been, these are an absolute blast, especially to take kids to for the first time. It is an entire room of trampolines. They do things like dodgeball and basketball. It's an absolute blast. Cost is totally worthwhile. I do believe they require socks, if I remember correctly, and they have specific socks that have a little bit of grippy on there just for safety reasons, but it's a really cool experience. You have parties, 3D golf, which is you go in there and they've got black lights everywhere. So if you have like neon shoelaces or white t-shirts or really cool you know, colors, it might be worthwhile wearing those types of things so that it shows off and it's kind of fun. But they have an 18-hole course. There's a couple of those in the area, but the one at Chesapeake is particularly fun. Something to, again, to do inside that's fun to do with the kids and is a unique experience. We have the Cinema Cafe, one of my absolute favorites. I love going to the movies. Sean does too. It's such a cool experience. The ability to go in, have a legitimately like a lazy boy with a little table. You can order a drink, you can order a beer, you can order nachos. If you want, you can press the button, it'll bring you a blanket. It is about as good as it gets as a home experience with a all the benefits of the movie theater, and plus you don't have to clean up afterwards. So just a really cool atmosphere, and in my opinion, one of my best favorite things to do if I want to do something indoors. Two notable mentions to just hear at the end is the Greenbrier Family Skating Center. Can't turn down the skating, that's always fun. And then it's called Glaze and Fire, which is one of those places where you can pick out like the pottery, you paint it there on site, and then they glaze and fire it for you so that you can actually go home and take, you know, some pottery or plates or utensils that you've painted, which is a really cool experience. I know Sean's wife loves to do stuff like that. I've only done it a few times, or if you just need a really good date activity, that might be a good one. Rolling on to number four for an outdoor activity is going to be golf courses. So Hampton Roads in general, or coastal Virginia, actually has a wide variety of golf courses. And Chesapeake has three of them to worth checking out. You have the Chesapeake, the Battlefield Golf Club, and the Greenbrier Country Club that all are options. Two of those are public. The last one is private, so you have to be a membership of that club. All of them are 18 holes over 6,100 yards long and range between 70 to a 72 par course. Sean is definitely a much bigger golfer than I am. I've been playing a lot of disc golf. I've played golf probably 24 times, not that great. Do a lot of Top Golf. We have one of those, but that's in Virginia Beach. I actually really do enjoy it, and Sean's been trying to convince me to go out and get a set of clubs so that we can go out and play more often. Rolling on to number five are just going to be some food options. Now, one of the things I think Coastal Virginia, all of Hampton Roads, does exceptionally well is that we have lots of just great food options. So I'm going to give you three here in Chesapeake worth checking out. Number one on this list is the Cutlass Grill. Sean and I just did a spotlight on this, about a month ago? And we have a private Facebook group, so if you end up becoming a client of one of ours, you'll be invited into that Facebook group. And we do giveaways at local restaurants and companies around the area. So we went to Cutlass Grill, Sean's first time for jerk chicken, absolutely phenomenal. I love Caribbean food, jerk chicken being one of my absolute favorites. And then we had this mango bread pudding, which was just probably one of my new favorite like desserts overall. Now, if you're on Google, right, and you see 2,100 positive reviews of a restaurant, you would think, this might be worth checking out. And the Egg Bistro is one of those that might be one of those. This is a breakfast and lunch place that is a super popular local spot and totally worth checking out. Lastly, we're going to mention Wicker's Crab Pot Seafood. This has been a staple in the area for over 40 years. Has been handed down to several generations and has been there for a very long time. So if you want to try some of these seasonal local seafood fare, this could be an absolutely wonderful spot to go check out. Hey, thanks again so much for watching my top five the fun things to do in Chesapeake. If you like those or agree with me, give me that like button. If you were gonna go out and check out one of these and hadn't heard of them before, give me that like button if I've earned it. If you'd like to see more content like this, we drop these things on Mondays and Fridays, and you can hit that subscribe button with the bell notification if you want to see all of it. And as much, again, as I like making this content, I'd love to help serve you and your family and your real estate needs. That's what we do on a daily basis. All of our contact information is down below, but if you want to just jump right into our calendars, there is a link to do that and schedule a time with us. So until next time, we'll talk to you later, Kova.